Brief presentation by Dr. Ilias Vanini, who is Deputy General Director for Research and Scientific Projects at the Sharjah Centre for Space Sciences and Astronomy, who's going to update on their present and their future plans. And then we follow along with these sessions looking at unlocking the potential of QSAT. So, Ilias, okay.
So let me talk about what we call the Sharjah Centre for Astronomy and Space Science. So it is a new center we opened about a year and a half, and let me talk about the present and also what we'll be doing hopefully in the next couple of years. So as I said, the center opened in May 2015, so up to now, so we are trying to build a program in terms of education, public outreach, and also research. So the center has different components. It has a very large planetarium. Before that, so let me invite all of you tomorrow. Tomorrow we have an open house for all the delegates. So there will be free planetarium shows. There will be all for sure free food, and also I get to have a live observation of the sun. So please, if you have time tomorrow, if you are still around, so please pass by Sharjah. If you take your plane from Dubai, before that, so please give us a visit. So we'll be very more than welcome to receive you. The whole university campus, the University of Sharjah, the American University of Sharjah, and also to the Levas Circle, which is our center. This is a big scale of it. So it looks like a mini solar system. So we have the sun at that golden globe, which is our planetarium. And also we have the cosmic garden. And here to the far, far right, we have our small observatory. So let me talk about this center. So let me talk first about the observatory, the planetarium, the exhibition hall, the cosmic park, and lastly, the research laboratory. So I will jump very fast about the planetarium, the exhibition, but I will take time to talk about the research laboratories. Let me start with the observatory. So this is our what we call the small bijou. So we have a very nice system of three telescopes. We have a 45 centimeter telescope that we can use to observe deep sky objects. Even though we are within Sharjah, it is quite light polluted, but we can do some small projects. We have also another telescope, 80 centimeter, to observe the moon planets. And we have also a 10 centimeter H-alpha telescope, so we can observe the sun. And to the right, we have our control room. So three telescopes, it was built by the German company BEDE, so it is working very fine. We have done several projects with our students because we are part of the University of Sharjah. We'll talk also about it. So we have done all these projects this past year. We're able to observe the sun, very high results of the sun, so very beautiful picture of the sunspots, of solar flares, also Jupiter. This is a very beautiful one. You have a double eclipse, and the of Jupiter is two closest moon. We can also observe the moon, and so on. This is a very good way to make what we call public outreach. So this is the May 9th Mercury transit. I believe you observed it. So it was very nice to gather all the people around the observatory to observe this unique Mercury crossing of the sun. About our planetarium, it's quite a big one. It can seat about 200 visitors. It has a very, very sophisticated megastar system that can project about 10 million stars. So tomorrow if you come, so you'll be pleased to at least to have three shows there. We have more than 50 space exhibitions inside the center. Physics experiment, space science experiment that school students from all ages, they can come, they can touch on, and they can play with all the experiments. So let me go there. So many experiments that you can do within the center. So that's why it is a very good attraction for all the school students around there. They will come and from Abu Dhabi to use it. So we use it all, as I say, for public outreach. This is my assistant, Mohammed Talabha. We have also a cafeteria, so if you feel hungry, so we have something to feed you. So in terms of the cosmic park, so as I said, so we have this very well thought design, not to scale for sure. So we have almost all the plants. We even kept any Pluto, so just to please President Trump, because it is there. So It's very nice design. So we received a visit of so many personalities. This is a very good one. Charles Bolden with the US ambassador, with Khalifa Rumaiti, the chairman of the US Space Agency. So we receive, we also do a lot of public shows. This is the astronaut Frank DeWitt. So he came to us in a couple of months. Also, we hold a very, very high scientific workshop. This is John Ellis, you may know him. And so we try to be as loud as possible, so whenever there's a big discovery, so we bring the right guy to talk to us, to talk to the, especially to the university student and also to our physics student. In terms of, as I say, we belong to the University of Sharjah, so that's why we have a student pool and of more than 4,000 students that we can use in all of our program. If I take the College of Engineering and Science all together, so we have 4,000 students. This is our MSc and also PhD students. So we have the number that I believe no university in the UAE has, with about 16,000 students. So we are number one in terms of number of students. In terms of the physics department, so we belong to the Applied Physics Astronomy Department. We have 45 students in physics. That's quite, I won't say world record, but that's an official record here. We have we give a BSc in Applied Physics, and hopefully next fall we're going to open an MSc in Astronomy and also Space Science. Presently we're giving these three courses, these three astronomy courses, and hopefully once the MSc will start, and we're going to offer the other courses for sure, and we're going to use the help of all the universities around and just as adjunct professors. So the research laboratory, so this is what we are building right now. So we have the center is not just a center like a visiting center. So it is a center for public outreach, for education, but also for research. That's why we are striving to build five labs, especially the METEORAS Center. And hopefully soon we're going to get, and it's something that we have the previous panel, we're going to get a system that will observe the space debris as they interact with the atmosphere, either being meteors or being just small debris burning out. So we have that METEORAS Center working. We also to have a radio astronomy lab, so I am a radio astronomer. There's also a new lab, what you call the atmospheric research lab, the interaction of the solar wind with the upper atmosphere. So we have a number of faculty members working in that laboratory. Also, as in university here, so there's a race to get your first CubeSat, but our CubeSat program is quite different. So we're getting parts from Radio Shack and try to build it. We're going to do it from scratch, and we're going to build every company using our students, because as I said, we have 4,000 students and we'd like to use them in this program. And also we have several other research centers belong to this. So our center is going to host these five labs, and why? Because it is what the astronomy and also space sciences in the center. So we'd like to be as close as possible to our title. What you see as FA and RA are just the number of faculty members, the research assistant, and also the student. So this is what we are winning at. And also we have a very good expertise. So this is our expertise at the University of Sharjah. We have more than 200 faculty members in the College of Engineering and Science. And this is the expertise, so we're going to use them in our labs. We get research money, so this is our three funders. So we have the US Space Agency, it does fund us. We have also the Mohammed Rashid Space Center, and also some money comes from the University of Sharjah. So we have a lot of resources that we can use to build our laboratories. We have a very heavy schedule. This is just to show you the schedule of this month. We have so many activities every on the first Saturday of every month, and we have a general lecture for the public. So we try to bring a big personality to give us a talk, so we can use it at SCAS, also gives the university. The second and the fourth Thursday of every month, we have open houses for the observatory, so we invite the public to come to us and to use the telescope to observe various objects. And also we have some special lectures every third Tuesday of the month. So we have a full program every month for everyone. And every weekday we receive hundreds of school students from all ages, from primary school to university students to use our facility. So I believe this is what we are, and thank you very much.